Okay, so again, good evening, everyone. So we are continuing our series on this March, sa On Call, which is the greatest physician, Jesus, the greatest physician, our Savior Jesus, and how he approaches different kinds of patients. So we believe na we want to become like Christ, and very weird, no? Kasi ang profession natin is we are medical professionals, we are medical students, then soon to be doctors. And there was a time in my life na gusto ko na mag-quit. Like, siguro dahil nahirapan talaga ako sa first year of medical school, and kinausap ako ni Doc Sam. Sabi niya, iba tayo yung profession natin, Bed, mga doktor. Pagtitingnan mo yung buhay ni Jesus, he healed the sick. Yung mga blind, nakakita, diba? And yung mga hindi nakakalakad, nakalakad. And that speaks volumes about Jesus being a healer, Jesus being a physician, and talagang unique yung profession natin. And that made me stay. And I think one of the reasons kung bakit andito pa rin ako in medicine is because I really do believe na Jesus is the greatest physician, and I want to be like him, no? So this month we will be focusing on that. Last week we had Doc Roxy talk about how Jesus tends to the hungry and the sick. Ang story nito is Jesus feeds the 5,000, and we learned how compassionate Jesus was, and as he provided for the needs of these hungry people. So kung hungry last week, ngayon naman, Jesus satisfies the thirsty. We will be learning about how Jesus, the great physician, how he satisfies the thirsty. And we'll be studying John chapter 4, verses 1 to 26. And speaking about thirst, no? I want us to all think about this question. What is your deepest desire? Ano yung isang bagay na talagang ninanais mo na makuha? What's one thing na you really want to experience? Gusto mo ba magka-love life? I think marami pa rin mga single dito, no? Gusto ba nating makapasa sa board exam? Na I think yun, very applicable ito sa mga ano natin, reviewees. Gusto ba nating yumaman? Gusto ba nating magka-family, maging successful? What is your deepest desire? What are you thirsty for? When you say thirst, kasi di ba, very it's something na common sa atin na talagang alam ng body mo, alam mo na when you are thirsty, hindi ka mapakali. Ano? Sometimes we cannot think straight when we are really thirsty. And I think it's the same thing with our other desires. And makes us really think, eh, ano ba yung something na talagang gusto nating makuha or ma-experience sa buhay? And we will be studying John chapter 4, wherein we see here the story of Jesus and the woman who had a lot of desires or marami siyang mga thirsts. Ano, and we will see paano kaya ito idinil. Ano kaya ang ginawa ni Jesus to deal with her, no? Hindi namang sinabi na talaga na patient niya naging patient yun ni Jesus, yung Samaritan woman. Pero we can see here how Jesus deals with her in her desires and in her thirsts. And hopefully we can see ourselves in and how Jesus caters to our desires and our thirsts. So let's dive into the story. John chapter 4, verses 1 to 26 lang pala ito, not until verse 27. Now Jesus learned that the Pharisees had heard that he was gaining and baptizing more disciples than John, although in fact it was not Jesus who baptized but his disciples. So, umalis siya ng Judea. He left Judea and he went back once more to Galilee. Now, Jesus learned that the Pharisees had heard... Oh, yeah, sorry. Twice. Now, he had to go through Samaria. So, kailangan niyang dumaan sa Samaria. And so, he came to a town in Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of ground Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was from the journey, sat down by the well. It was about noon, okay? So, noon time ito. When a Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Will you give me a drink?" His disciples had gone into the town to buy food, and the Samaritan woman said to him, "Wait lang, you are a Jew, and I am a Samaritan woman. How do you ask me for a drink? For Jews do not associate with Samaritans." So a little context lang, talagang kagulat-gulat itong ginawa ni Jesus kasi itong mga Samaritans and itong mga Hudyo, they are not in good terms. Talagang masama ang tingin nila sa isa't isa. And yet, here is Jesus, tinatanong niya itong Samaritan woman for a drink. Ano? And Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water." "Sir," the woman said, "you have nothing to draw with and the well is deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, as did also his sons and his livestock?" And Jesus answered, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again." Yung iinom doon sa well ni Jacob. "But whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of water welling up to eternal life." So the woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and have to keep coming here to draw water." And very weird ang sinabi ni Jesus. Sabi niya, he told her, "Go call your husband and come back." "I have no husband," she replied. And Jesus said to her, "You are right when you say you have no husband. The fact is, you have had 5 husbands, and the man you now have is not your husband. What you have just said is quite true." "Sir," the woman said, "I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you Jews claim that the place where we must worship is in Jerusalem." "Woman," Jesus replied, "believe me, a time is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You Samaritans worship what you do not know. We worship what we do know, for salvation is from the Jews. Yet a time is coming and has now come when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For they are the kind of worshipers the Father seeks. God is spirit, and his worshipers must worship in the spirit and in truth." The woman said, "I know that Messiah, called the Christ, is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us." Then Jesus declared, "I, the one speaking to you, am he." So praise God for his amazing word. So this is a very interesting conversation with a Samaritan woman and with Jesus. And para maintindihan natin deeper anong nangyayari dito, let's look a little into the details. No? So first, merong isang woman, and this is not just any woman, this is a Samaritan woman. And again, sa sinabi ko, hindi nag-a-associate, no, ang mga Samaritans and mga Jews, dahil talagang pangit yung history nila. Talagang merong anger and bitterness between the Samaritans and the Jews. So kaya na-shock yung Samaritan nung kinausap siya bigla ni Jesus. Another din is usually itong mga babae, kapag pag pumunta sila, nag-iigib sila ng tubig na nag they go they get water sa mga wells. They come in groups. Okay? Madami sila. Siguro dahil mag-chika-chika, ganun, or nagtutulungan sila. Pero pag mapapansin nyo, itong Samaritan woman, she is going there alone. Mag-isa. Bakit kaya? Another din is, kapag nagkumukuha itong mga women, they go to the wells para mag-igib, usually it's during the dawn, yung early morning, 7, 8 o'clock, or yung paggabi na. Bakit? Dahil mainit. Ano, there's that under the heat of the sun. Kapag noon time ka pumunta. Pero pag titingnan mo dito, this Samaritan woman, she goes alone and in the noon time. So, mag-isa siya at sobrang init. Bakit kaya? So, malalaman natin dito na talagang pangit, no, yung history at talagang very messy yung buhay and itong Samaritan woman. She has had 5 husbands. So sa ibang translation, 5 men. Meaning we can say na yung sexual history niya napakasaklap. She has had very broken beginnings and shattered hopes. And makikita mo na ang dami niyang mga unsatisfied desires and longings. And ang nangyari dito is Jesus saw through her. Nakita ni Jesus kung sino talaga itong babae na ito. Si Jesus, no, with his wisdom, nakita niya ano talaga yung tunay na problema nitong Samaritan woman. What's really curious is itong verses na ito, 'di ba? The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water." Kasi nag-aaral sila, nag-uusap na sila about this living water from this yung iniisip ng Samaritan woman is physical water. Dinala ni Jesus into, sabi niya, no, hindi lang ito physical water, but what I will give you is spiritual na living water welling up to eternal life. Ang sinasabi ni Jesus is parang dinadala niya from physical na conversation, physical things, dinadala ni Jesus to talking about spiritual things. So, pero hindi pa rin tumagets ng Samaritan woman. So sabi ng Samaritan woman, "Sir, ibigay mo nga sa akin itong tubig na ito para hindi na ako mauhaw. And para, no, hindi na ako pabalik-balik dito. And I have to keep coming here to draw water." And very weird ang sinabi, ang reply ni Jesus. Sabi niya, "Go call your husband and come back." So, for me, very weird yun na bakit kaya ito yung tinanong ni Jesus na, "Go call your husband." Na nung nagtanong yung woman about this thirst. And I think dinadala talaga ni Jesus, pinaparealize niya sa Samaritan woman na ito na she is really thirsty. She is longing for something na hinahanap niya in the wrong way. In this case, hinahanap niya sa lalaki, no? By having all of these different husbands. I think ang gusto na iparealize ni Jesus sa kanya is you are finding what you are looking for in the wrong places. So go call your husband. And dito tuloy nalaman na wala pala siyang husband or meron na siyang 5 men na who she has had sexual relations with, no? And she has had a very broken na lifestyle. So ang diagnosis ni Jesus na nakikita natin dito is this woman is spiritually thirsty. She is hungry for something na her soul, no, is searching for, is longing for. At hindi niya yun nahanap. Until nung encounter niya with Jesus, hinahanap niya pa rin yun. Yung something na makakapag-satisfy ng kanyang kaluluwa. So, There's this one scholar, si John Calvin, sabi niya, the human heart is a factory of idols. Now, when you say na idols, it's something na nire-replace natin sa Diyos, sa ating puso. Every one of us, no, yung puso natin, kasi si Lord ang gumawa. So, si Lord lang talaga ang makakasatisfy ng ating kaluluwa. Pero what we do, dahil hindi natin kilala talaga si Lord, or we are hungry, no? We're constantly thirsty for something. Humahanap tayo ng replacements. Yun na yung ano, humahanap tayo ng idols. And sometimes, hindi naman siguro tulad nung sa Samaritan woman, no, na hinahanap niya sa sex. Some of us, we find it in achievements. We want to be satisfied sa ating mga grades, or na pag masabi, doktor na ako, pag naging doktor na ako, magiging maligaya na ako, I will be happy. Some of us, we find our satisfaction sa ating mga love life, 'di ba? And achievements and wealth, success. Pero again, that's the human tendency na i-replace natin ang Diyos to what our soul is really longing for, what we are spiritually thirsty for. And since our diagnosis, no, is we are spiritually thirsty, the solution that Jesus proposes is that He Himself is the solution. Siya lang talaga, no? Kasi siya kasi ang gumawa ng puso natin, eh. And I believe na God created us for a purpose. And yung purpose na yun is parang makilala natin siya and masatisfy tayo sa pag-ibig ng Diyos, sa kanyang presence in our lives. And we will find that peace, that contentment, that joy in His, na sa kanya lang natin makikita, hindi sa mga replacements or sa mga counterfeit, no, na mga pwede nating ipang replace for Him. Sabi pa ni Saint Augustine, "You have made us for yourself, O Lord, and our hearts are restless until they find rest in you." And I believe this is true, no? Kapag hindi pa natin kilala si Lord, or there are times na napapalayo tayo kay Lord, those are the times na parang restless tayo, parang nauuuhaw yung kaluluwa natin. And we try to find replacements, we try to fill in the gaps para satisfy tayo. Ako, I don't know kung ano yung struggle ninyo or ano yung mga pinagdadaanan ninyo. I believe magkaiba-iba tayo, no, ng parang nire-replace para kay Lord. Ako before, nung hindi ko pa kilala si Lord, during high school, I was really hungry for achievements. Talagang gusto kong makatap. So, nung high school ako, nung grade 8, ganun, medyo nag-angat na ako somehow, so naging top 9. Pero it was not enough. So, yun, naging top 6, tapos talaga naging top 5 nung nadumpa ako sa regional science side. Pero it was not enough, no? And it consumed my life na I wanted to achieve more. And hindi lang yun, meron din akong niligawan. Pero no, high school again, pero meron akong niligawan. Pero nung sinagot niya ako, nag-chat din ako sa ibang mga babae. No, so parang hindi pa rin ako naging kontento na meron akong relationship. I still wanted to communicate with other girls. Ganun, and talagang ang pangit, no? Nung nakilala ko si Jesus, I started to realize na talagang iba pala yung nandiyan ka sa Diyos, na you realize na, this is why I exist, para makilala ko si Lord. And I felt that satisfaction. I experienced that. And hanggang ngayon naman, no, hindi naman ako perfect, and we are still in this world. So, yun, I am still tempted towards other things. Merong mga times na nakakaligtaan ko yung spending time with the Lord. And ang nangyayari, whenever I don't put God first, magulo talaga yung araw. And I keep being distracted dami ko mga parang, you know, desires pulling me left and right. Isa sa mga biggest ko talaga na struggles, which is deep-rooted, and I'm very open about this, pero very hard to confess, is ang aking struggles with pornography. So, yan talaga, that's a very spiritual thirst na hanggang ngayon, I am still fighting against dahil very early in life ako na-expose. So, yun, ang reflection ko talaga is hindi masasatisfy yung kaluluwa natin, yung spiritual thirst natin, unless we find our satisfaction in Jesus. And na-amaze lang talaga ako kay Jesus dahil nakita niya yun sa Samaritan woman. No, yung Samaritan woman, gusto niya pag-usapan yung physical water. And that's true. Kailangan nating ng water, no, ng physical water. Pero ang talagang pina-realize, I think, ni Jesus, or gusto niyang iparating doon sa Samaritan woman, and I hope sa atin today, is that there is a need beyond our physical needs na kailangang masatisfy. And that is our spiritual thirst na si Jesus lang ang makakasatisfy, makakapuno. Sabi pa ni Jesus, doon sa binasa natin kanina, whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. And I think that's truly the satisfaction, the kind of contentment na nabibigay ni Jesus through the Holy Spirit sa atin. When we seek Him, when we open up our hearts for Him to fill us, when we put Him first, no? When we refocus our priorities and say, na, Jesus, can you just fill me? May you satisfy me. And I pray na you will just take over my life with all of my desires, no, left and right, pulling me from different sides. Help me, Jesus, to be satisfied in you alone. So our application is, let us have our deepest thirst, no, our deepest thirst, be satisfied in Jesus alone. Walang replacement, no? And being filled, being satisfied in Christ alone. So ang questions siguro for our breakout session is, what is your deepest desire in life? And how can you allow Jesus to satisfy, to fill, no, your deepest desires? So pwede nyo ito i-screenshot. Never mag breakout sessions tayo. So thank you so much, guys. God bless.